Today, RefurbishLab will demonstrate the refurbishment of the iPad Pro 3 front glass. Almost all iPad models use LCD screens, which have two structures, laminated and non-laminated. In this video, we focus on sharing tips on how to refurbish a laminated display. Let's dive in. Refurbishment tools and machines include screen separator, laminating and debubbling machine, cutting wire, and degluing tool. These tools and machines are available for purchase in the Refurbish online store. First, test the functions. The display and touch function normally. Due to the broken edge and corner around the glass, tape it together before separation. In order to prevent glass shards from scratching the touchscreen. Simultaneously, the tape's stickiness maintains glass's overall integrity, which helps the glass adhere better to the separation platform. Puncture the large bubbles trapped during tape bonding, allowing glass to adhere better to the separation platform. Smooth out the tape across the entire glass. This method protects our hands from being injured by shards. Before separation, remove the glass corner's residual adhesive where the cutting wire will enter. Since residual glue will cause the cutting angle of the wire to be inaccurate, which will increase risk of damaging the touch panel. While separating, set the temperature of the separation station to 80 degrees Celsius. Note that excessive heating may damage the LCD. It is recommended to limit the operation time less than 10 minutes. What kind of cutting wire we recommend for separating iPad screens? If the wire that is too thin will easy to break. Considering of security and efficiency, RefurbishLab recommends using 0.1 mm wire. Now, let's start to separate. We suggest starting from intact corners. Inexperienced beginners sometimes choose damaged corners to enter the wire. But lack of reference position from the glass, the cutting wire may easily enter the touch layer, resulting in damage. Pay attention that it is safer to find the gap between the touch layer and the glass for entry. First, pull the cutting wire to cut out a small triangle. Switch to the opposite corner and cut out another triangle. Next, insert the cutting wire parallel to the screen to continue separation. Repeat this sequence from the left and right sides towards the center, until the glass and LCD are completely separated. With this method, the cutting wire is easier to pull, requires less effort, and is less likely to break. The next step is to remove the residual adhesive. It is commonly used an electric glue removing tool, or an OSEA glue remover. If using OSEA glue remover, be cautious with the amount applied. Since iPads are equipped with an LCD backlight screen, excessive drops may damage the backlight. Therefore, we recommend beginners use the electric glue removing tool. Place the LCD on the separation platform, and heat it to 55 degrees Celsius. Heating can make adhesive removal easier, but the temperature shouldn't be too high, and there's no need to activate the suction function. The correct use of the glue removing tool involves two tips. First, gently roll up a small amount of residual adhesive with the tool's head. Keep the tool's head parallel to the LCD and move it slowly. Second, due to the large size of the iPad, when the degluing tool cannot be parallel to the LCD at the center, lift the head slightly, suspending it about 2 to 3 millimeters above the LCD surface. The rotating head can automatically remove nearby residual adhesive. After removing a large area of residual adhesive, thoroughly clean the LCD with N-heptin and a sponge. Residual adhesive on the back and around the edges of the LCD can affect the lamination and must be thoroughly cleaned. We recommend testing the display and touch function after each step of the operation, in order to pinpoint where the issue occurred. Next, proceed with the lamination operation. Place the LCD into the mold. Here, you'll need a dust-free environment. Clean the LCD again to prevent dust from affecting the lamination process. This REWA Select glass replacement comes pre-installed with OCA, using Mitsubishi. Use pull tape to peel off the protective film from the glass. Place the glass into the mold. Then lightly press the center of the screen to partially adhere the glass to the LCD, preventing misalignment. Place the screen into the multifunctional machine. And turn on the machine. After finishing the lamination and bubble removal, let's test. The display and touch functions are normal. Summary of key points for this refurbishment. For more refurbishment skills, kindly visit REWA Academy.